Minnesota Wild vs. Chicago Blackhawks. Damn, these Hawks are good enough. They're finally back in an anger. Hopefully they can beat the Blue Jackets tomorrow night. That team's really weak, but do the Hawks have the chance on a Friday to kick your ass? Can they do it again as they done last time with Tate, but no longer with Tate with their new centerman now? I really didn't pay attention in the first third of the new centerman they had. Because I didn't really care to see the first or second, because I thought they were about to lose, but now that I see them winning, now I decided, you know what, 8 minutes. I was hoping for 12 minutes, but no. Usually sometimes I watch that they get a tied game, sometimes they lose sometimes. Not really, but they lose a lot of games, these Hawks, but now if they can break this three game losing streak, they can take one win. They can beat the Blue Jacks tomorrow to beat the second win. So good luck to these Hawks without Tate and Kane. Hopefully Kane and Tate are way better in the playoffs. They come back. Hopefully they can beat the Avalanche if they take on them first.
Little bit of a rebound there and ends up going past.
Crawford's amazing. If he's anti-Vanta, he would miss so much. Just saying.
Now Pominville in.
Next season, the hockey will be a little bit more different. There might be the first game of hockey, but the rest, I have no idea. There might be at least maybe four only hockey games of the Hawks. The rest will be without a thing, because I might be very busy those past next season of hockey.
And it might have been blocked out in front of the net. Back comes Hossa. Hossa dropped in the deep, back to Hossa. And he shot one right through the goal crease. And now the Wild, Pominville had it but lost to the Kruger. He looks in front. Oh, picked out a bit there by Brodziak. Good play by Brodziak. Lars Chalmerson was going to have a good chance.